In previous session, in the previous class, already we discussed the Russian Revolution, the Russian Socialist Revolution, that is the March Revolution, right? Now, that is the March Revolution. The March Revolution happened only for peace and bread. Right? It's here for peace and bread. So only if the start, the revolution starts only women. The women's will start, the 10,000 women came into the street and the start agitation against the Nicholas II, the judge Nicholas II. Then automatically soldiers were supported, then automatically all over the people were supported, and finally the Nicholas II escaped from the country. The throne is left his throne and they come, then automatically they start provisional government form. Provisional government form. See, the before we the going to the next topic, we'll discuss the how the women, the how the 10,000 women they started. The only one woman, you can't underestimate the woman empower. You can't underestimate the woman's power. The woman's strength that nobody will knows. They what they have, the what they have. The woman's heart is a very deep of secrets. The woman's heart is a very deep of secrets. If they try to be willing to do something, they can do anything. The one woman name is the Marfa Vasileva. Marfa Vasileva. She is working in Lawrence telephone factory. She is working in Lawrence telephone factory as a mailing department. Marfa Vasileva working is the Lawrence telephone factory as a working as a mailing work, the mailing worker. And she, the one day, is of which particular day, the 8th March, what we call nowadays the Women's Day. What we call 8th March? Women's Day. In the 8th March, she stopped the work, and she stopped the work and she sat on the floor for the agitation, for the demand of the peace and bread, the demand of the bread. And they start the Marfa Vasileva in the agitation of the bread. So the management observed, the worker observed, and they took the management. The management gave chance to the bread hut. She took a bread and ate it, and the continuous the agitation started continuing. Then the management said, already you demanded for the bread and we provide the bread, then get up and go for the work. And she said, I cannot be one satisfied. Why? Because the others were angry. I can't do my work. Why? Because you can provide others also to the bread, right? So due to this statement, the floors, those who are the working on the floors, those are when they came to the support act. They came and the support act they sat to the agitation. So not only the women, also the men's also came. So this is the afternoon session that will be closed. This is closed very soon. Then they all the ran into the office. They all ran into the street. They went the all the ran into the street. So one by one is the this kind of news spread like a fire war. It's the spread like a the spy war. Then automatically then came to the all the Saint Petersburg almost 10,000 women. You can see the only one woman, that lady, she was a Marfa Vasileva. The Marfa Vasileva start the revolution. That revolution took as a the Russian king, the Nicholas Russian king Nicholas II, the left his throne and flew out of the country. After the Nicholas II's of course escaped from the country, and then the started is a provisional government. Which government? Provisional government. In this provisional government, this started in 1970. In this provisional government, only two, what is the liberals and aristo, aristocrats. Which one, Nana? The liberals and aristocrats, they ruled the provisional government, which was the after the Nicholas Tulip. Is the liberal those who are the called intellectuals? The aristocrats means these are the family members of kings or queens. The family members of the kings are the queens. These all are the, when we case is the Bahubali. In the Bahubali, Mahishmati called the Rajavamshisthu. The Rajavamshisthu, right? These are the Ranas, Prabha, these are. So these are the aristocrats. These are the aristocrats, these are the family members of the king and queens. They are ruling the provisional government. People already they thought, why? Because the end of the war, if the due to the war, we can't eat sufficiently. Why? Because the most of the food, the provided most of the food is distributed, provided to the wars. So due to the war, already we lose 2 million people, 2 million soldiers and the people. Then why should we go? So due to this, the agitation started the March Revolution. But what they are doing the provisional government? They also continuing the war, why? Because they took a pride of nation, the pride of nation. So when this decision is happening, when this decision made by the provisional government, then again agitation is start. Is agitation is the where danger of revolution is the more than is compared to the March Revolution. That is called October Revolution. October Revolution is a more popular than the March Revolution. Right, the October Revolution. See, the October Revolution is compared to the March Revolution is more powerful. Why? Because in the March Revolution, only the workers of the women workers and this kind of worker participated. But when it comes to the October Revolution, all villagers people, those who are the agriculturists, those who are the soldiers, these all of the participated. This is the October Revolution. And they started agitation against to the government. Agitation against to the, which is led by the provisional government. See, this government has to be in the peace and to provide the bread. But instead of, they are going to the pride of the Russia. So that's why these people, those who are, they collect all those villagers, agriculturists, their factory members, workers, women, these are soldiers. These all are gathered from there as a group. And they call themselves Soviets. And they call themselves the Soviets. This is an important word. This is why they call themselves the Soviets. This is the Soviet group. This is the Soviet group to provide agitation against the government. And one of the Russian Communist Party. One of the group, the Russian Communist Party is the one of the group is called Bolshevik. Bolsheviks. The Bolsheviks getting supported to the Soviets. The Bolshevik, this group, supported to the Soviets due to this agitation. Supported to the Soviets due to this agitation. See, in this agitation, in the Soviet Union become supported by the Bolsheviks, they got a huge impact. This got a huge impact. In this Bolshevik, the well-known leader is Vladimir is not a Putin, is Vladimir Lenin, 1870 to 1924. He was the one of the greatest leader is produced by the Russia, is a communist party. is one of the greatest leader. Is Lenin has the impact in the all over world is a very strong. Lenin has the impact all over world is a very strong. In the Vladimir Lenin is a demanded to the provisional government is a unconditional peace and immediate is unconditional and immediate peace. Unconditional and immediate peace. We need unconditional and immediate peace. And also those who are the land. Why? Because this land has all of this land occupied is controlled by the feudal lords. Right? These all are land, Russian land is controlled by the feudal lords. So that's why the land has to be redistributed. Land has to be redistributed. And also the factories which are led by these factories has to be comes under nationalized. This factory has to become under nationalized. And also these are the many the power. They ask for the price. Those are the price has to be decreased. Right? The price has to be decreased and provided to each and everyone's bill. So due to this demand, the Bolshevik is got a very born, is got a very born support to the people. This very huge support to the people. So due to this huge support, then automatically the provisional government has to be ended. To suspend the provisional government. See, this when it comes to the provisional government suspend, this is the end of the Russian era. This is the king or queens, all those things. The end of the Russian era. Then the people were thought, now we have the very peaceful. But when it came to the after the provisional government cancelled, when it came to the Bolshevik, they distributed all land and they withdraw the World War I in 1970, right? After the Civil War end, they withdraw World War I in 1970. But what the Russian people, they thought we need peace. But it happened, no. First they thought in the March Revolution, they couldn't get in the another big revolution they started in the October Revolution. Then after the October Revolution, the Russian, they thought that peace will be happen. But it's not gonna happen in the peace. What will happen, Nana? Those who are the provisional government, they formed a white army. They got a white army, which is called, is a anti-communist, we can call the anti-communist or anti-Bolsheviks. Yes, anti-communist and the anti-Bolsheviks. Why? Because this is supported, this anti-army, the white army is supported by the France and UK, nothing but Britain and USA. Why? Because the provisional government, they want to continue the war. So automatically, this Bolsheviks, they oppose to the war, they need a peace. So due to this, they have allies, the France, UK, USA. They formed a white army and they supported to and agitated against the those who are the formed by the Bolshevik government. But is 1920. In 1920, this all the this white armies and this supported by the France, UK, and USA. This all are defeated by the Bolsheviks. And finally, the Bolshevik has a war. Then the when the Bolshevik war, they are the formed many new countries like Uzbekistan, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, Kazakhstan, Ukraine, these all are the countries formed. And finally you got a USSR. This formed in the USSR. What is the mean by USSR? United Soviet United Soviet Socialist United Soviet Socialist and R for Russia. Those who are the newly formed countries, they all are the agreed. They all are agreed to join in the USSR. They all are agreed to join in the USSR. USSR. Then the 1922, the USSR were formed. The United Soviet Socialist Russia. Then after the USSR, then we'll discuss in this section the rise of Stalin and the continuation. Thank you.